Okay. Let us discuss, okay, the Philippine Cooperative Code of 2008. Okay, now this is Republic Act 9520, okay, amending Republic Act 6938. By the way, this law, okay, was approved on February 17, 2009, and the law took effect on March 22, 2009. Okay, kaya lumalabas March 22, 2009. Okay, covered siya yun ng Republic Act 9520. Now, let us, okay, proceed sa table of specification. By the way, we are expecting, of course, 10 questions. Okay, starting May 2019 and onward. Okay? Okay, unless of course nag-issue ang okay, BOA ng another TOS. Okay, but in so far as okay, for October 2020 sana board exams. Okay? Malamang sa May 2021 ganyan din. 10 questions for cooperatives. Kaya medyo bulky yung questions dito. Okay, medyo marami yung tanong. Okay. Kaya actually kunin niyo nga lang yung obligation and contract, yung partnership, yung corporation. Okay, tapos itong cooperative, o ilan na yan? 10, 20, 30, 40, 56, 68 ka na kaagad. Okay? Plus 7. Okay, 75 questions. Okay. Bali, let us proceed now dun sa syllabus. By the way, yung sa cooperative, ang syllabus na nakalagay doon, ito, cooperatives describe organization and registration of cooperatives, explain administration, describe the responsibilities, rights, and privileges of cooperatives, explain capital, property of funds, explain audit, inquiry, and members' right to examine, describe allocation and distribution of funds, enumerate the types and categories of cooperatives, explain merger and consolidation of cooperatives, and explain dissolution of cooperatives. Actually, yung mga nakikita nyo dyan, mga heading yan, mga title. Kaya parang technically, you need to read the entire provision of the cooperative law. Now, before, okay, ang cooperative is governed ng Republic Act 6938. But of course, okay, yung provision dito was amended by Republic Act 9520. Bali, ito na tinatawag na Philippine Cooperative Code of 2008. And of course, Republic Act 6939, this is the act creating the Cooperative Development Authority. Kasi lumalabas yung CDA, sila yung lumalabas na administrative agency na may general supervision over all cooperative. Okay? Now, now, let us proceed now sa policy of the state. Okay? Pagdating sa special laws, okay, you need to look the policy of the state so that you can see the intention of the lawmaker. Para makita ninyo kung ano ba yung policy, okay? Bakit na-enact itong laws na to. Now, mapapansin nyo nakalagay, number one, to foster the creation and growth of cooperative as a practical vehicle for promoting self-reliance. Harnessing people power toward the attainment of economic development and social justice. The state shall encourage private sector to undertake the actual formation and organization of cooperatives. Kaya ibig sabihin, ina-encourage of course ng state, okay, yung pag, okay, create or organize ng cooperative. Kaya kung merong provision dito class sa cooperative law na doubtful, normally it re-resolves siya in favor of okay the cooperative. Now, okay, principles of subsidiarity. Okay, tingnan niyo tong ibig sabihin ng principle of subsidiarity. Makita mo yan sa Article 2 ng Republic Act 9520. Sabi diyan, the cooperative sector will initiate and regulate within its own rank. Yun ang ibig sabihin ng principle of subsidiarity. Okay, yung cooperative daw, okay, sila yung mag-initiate at mag-regulate ng kanilang own ranks, meaning yung own member nila for the promotion, organization, training and research, audit and support services relative to cooperatives with government assistance where necessary. Okay, now, requisite of cooperative. Actually, ito galing lang ito dun sa definition. Okay, nung cooperative under, okay, Article 3. Sabi dyan, okay, cooperative is an autonomous. Okay, dapat independent. Okay, kaya ibig sabihin, every time class na yung cooperative ay merong transaction with government or other agency or other or third person, kailangan walang provision doon na pwedeng mag-interfere yung lender doon sa operation ng cooperative. Kasi otherwise, mababiolate yung okay, pagiging independent and autonomous ng cooperative. Kailangan free sila from any interference from outside. And duly registered association of person. Kasi take note, ang cooperative, okay, magko-commence lang ang due, okay, kanyang legal personality from the time of the issuance of the certificate of registration under the seal of the authority. Kaya ibig sabihin, okay, kailangan ma-registered siya before the Cooperative Development Authority. Kasi hanggat hindi nag-i-issue ang CDA ng Certificate of Registration, walang separate legal personality ang cooperative. It means they are just, okay, a group of individual with no legal personality. A mere association of person lang. Next, with a common bond of interest. Okay, ito yung kakaiba sa cooperative. Meron dapat silang common bond of interest. Now, under the implementing rules, okay, pwede nyong gamitin ang common bond of membership nila. Okay, number one is residential. Ibig sabihin, dapat lahat ng members must be residing on the same locality. Or pwede siyang institutional. It means yung mga members belong to the same institution. Okay, tulad sa amin. Okay, member ako ng cooperative. Okay, sa FEU. Okay, credit cooperative. Member din ako sa FEU Consumer Cooperative. Now, ang common bond of membership namin, of course, is institutional. Kasi lumalabas ang pwede lang maging member nito are those employees of the same institution. Okay, kaya mga faculty members, okay, kaya yun yung lumalabas na ginamit na common bond of interest. Or pwede rin class na occupational. Ibig sabihin, dapat yung mga members, okay, belong to the same occupation. Halimbawa, farmers cooperative. Eh di dapat lahat ng members dun must be, okay, farmers, di ba? Okay, now, kaya lumalabas, okay, yun yung pwede nyong gamitin as common bond of interest. O kaya associational. It means the members belong to the same association. Kaya doon sa implementing rules, isa lang yung kailangan yung gamitin. Pwede nyong basta gamitin either residential, okay, pwedeng occupational, institutional, or associational. Basta kailangan mayroon kayong common bond of interest. Next, voluntary join together daw. Okay, to achieve their social, economic, and cultural needs and aspiration. Now, making equitable contribution to the capital required. O, ibig sabihin, kailangan merong contribution. Okay, pero equitable in the sense that yung member hindi naman pwedeng magbigay ng sobrang laki-laking capitalization. Okay, in fact, okay, under the cooperative law, the maximum, okay, capital lang na pwede sa members ng primary cooperative is only up to 10% of the share capital. Okay, pero I'm referring to primary, ha? Members ng primary cooperative except the cooperative itself. Kaya hanggang 10% lang. Okay, bawal lumagpas ng 10%. Kasi otherwise, pag lumagpas ng 10%, babalik lang yun sa cooperative. At babayaran ka lang nung interest. Okay, another is patronizing their products and services. Kasi normally, ang mga cooperative, ang transaction niyan is with members. Pero may mga cooperative na ang transaction is with members as well as non-members. Okay, in fact, okay, if the members of the cooperative do not patronize the product, okay, of the cooperative, okay, and services for unreasonable period of time, ground dyan for termination of membership. Okay, kasi dapat pinapatronize, of course, ng mga members, okay, yung kanilang product and services. And of course, accepting a fair share of the risk and benefit of the undertaking in accordance with the general accepted cooperative principle daw. Now, what are the characteristic of cooperative? The first characteristic of cooperative, okay, is limited liability. Because the members are liable only, okay, to the extent of their contribution. Kaya ibig sabihin, kapag halimbawa ang cooperative ay naging insolvent, hindi liable, of course, ang mga members. Kasi limited liability. Limited life, because ang cooperative, meron lang siyang maximum life na pwedeng i-state sa Article of Cooperation na 50 years lang. But of course, pwede siyang i-renew for another 50 years. Okay, now, meron daw siyang right of succession. Kasi take note that if a member die, hindi siya magkukos ng dissolution ng cooperative. Because the interest of the okay members is simply transmitted to the legal heirs by operation of law, provided of course the legal heirs are capable to succeed. Okay, meaning qualified siya for membership. Kaya ibig sabihin, kahit mamatay mo yung members, hindi siya magkukos ng dissolution kasi may right yung cooperative na mag-exist dun sa period na naka-indicate sa Article of Cooperation. Okay, pero hindi siya lalagpas ng 50 years. Now, next, it is created by law. In other words, you cannot create a cooperative by mere agreement. There must be a consent coming from the state. And of course, the consent given by the state is through the enactment of RA 9520. Okay? Yung cooperative law. Kasi ibig sabihin, okay, bago makakuha ang cooperative ng okay, separate legal personality, kailangan i-comply nila lahat ng requirements set forth by law. Kasi take note that a cooperative commences legal personality from the time of the issuance ng certificate of okay registration under the seal of the authority. And of course, may naiwan pa lang isa yung number 4. It has a juridical personality. Okay, separate and distinct from the members composing it. Kaya lumalabas, magkaiba yung cooperative dun sa member. Kaya yung cooperative, pwede silang mag-acquire ng property in their own name. They can sue and they can be sued. Now, number and qualification of incorporator organizer. Let us compare sa corporation law. Before kasi sa BP 68, diba, not less than 5 but not more than 15, but under RA 11232, not more than 15 in numbers. Pero sa cooperative, okay, 15 or more natural person dapat ang kanilang organizer. Pero take note, yung natural person, 15 or more natural person, I'm referring to a primary cooperative. Kasi tandaan nyo ha, okay, ang cooperative pwedeng primary, secondary, or tertiary. Pag primary, ang member is natural person. Pag secondary, ang member is primary. And tertiary, the members are secondary. Kaya technically, yung secondary and tertiary cooperative, okay, ang members niyan ay juridical person. Cooperative, okay, ang lumalabas na okay members nila, which is yung primary nga. Okay, saka yung okay, malumalabas is secondary, primary yung members nila. Okay, tapos doon sa tertiary, yung secondary, which is a juridical person. Okay, kaya tandaan nyo ha, yung tinutukoy ko dyan, primary cooperative lang siya. Okay, as to qualification sa corporation, kailangan, okay, dapat yung incorporators must be an owner of at least one share of stock. Pero sa cooperative, dapat ang organizer must be natural person. Okay, pero primary cooperative lang siya. Citizen of the Philippines. Okay. Dapat citizen of the Philippines sila. Okay, meron silang common bond of interest. And dapat residing or working sila sa intended area of operation. Yan ang requirement. Now, let us proceed na sa section 4 on cooperative principles. Sabi dyan, every cooperative daw shall conduct its affair in accordance with Filipino culture, good values and experience, and the what we call universally accepted principle of cooperation. Sabi dyan, this include daw, but not limited to the following. Kaya ibig sabihin, hindi lang siya limited rito. Okay? Pero din yung lumalabas na para mga example natin ng mga universally accepted principle of cooperation. Number one is voluntary and open membership. Ibig sabihin, yung cooperative daw, open to anyone. Okay? As long as they are willing to accept their obligation, okay, as member. Okay? And of course, okay, regardless of their religion, gender, religious, political, okay, affiliation. Okay, or wala dapat discrimination. Kaya halimbawa, yung cooperative nakalagay dun na ang members lang nito, bawal ang babae, nagdi-discriminate as to gender. Okay, that is not allowed. Okay. O kaya dapat, okay, member lang siya dapat ng ganitong political party. Okay, bawal yun. Kasi nagkakaroon kayo ng discrimination. Basta tandaan nyo, dapat open. Okay, voluntary and open membership siya. Okay, open to anyone siya. Okay, pangalawa, democratic member control. Kasi take note that in a cooperative setup, okay, members ang nagmamanage, okay, lumalabas ang nag-operate ng cooperative. Okay, and take note, democratic siya in the sense that each member has one vote regardless of his capitalization. Kaya kahit mas malaki yung capital na kinontribute mo, one member, one vote pa rin tayo. Okay? Kasi democratic members control tayo. Another is member economic participation. Kasi dumalabas yung each members, required silang magbigay ng capital contribution. Autonomy and independence. Okay? O, kailangan daw yung cooperative must be autonomous and independent dapat siya. Kaya ibig sabihin, every time na yung cooperative, nagkakaroon siya ng transaction, okay, with government or other institution, dapat walang provision dun na those, okay, lender or third person will interfere with the management. Kasi kung pwede mag-interfere yun sa management ng cooperative, mawawala ng independent yung cooperative. Education, training, and information. Kasi dapat dito kasi yung cooperative, okay, nagkakaroon sila ng education for their members. Okay, saka yung mga officers. Okay, para maging more efficient. Kaya nga pagdating doon sa net surplus ng cooperative, meron tayong statutory reserve na tinatawag na education and training fund. Okay, by the way, yan, natatanong siguro sa board exam yan, yung tinatawag nating statutory reserve. Pag sinasabing statutory reserve, ito yung portion ng net surplus na hindi pwedeng galawin kasi naka-reserve by law. Okay, tulad ng reserve fund na 10% ng net surplus, tapos 10% din ang education and training fund, tapos 3% sa community development fund, and 7% for the optional fund. Kaya lumalabas, pag tinotal mo siya, 30% yung statutory reserve. In other words, okay, only 70% may be distributed to the okay members in the form of interest on share capital and the patronage refund. Now, kaya yun, nag-a-allocate tayo ng 10% okay for education and training. Nadidivide pa nga yan ito 5% for education and training at yung another 5% ibibigay yan sa union or federation kung saan affiliated with ang cooperative. Next, cooperation among cooperatives daw. Okay, kaya dito papasok yung mga union saka yung federation kasi nagiging mas productive ang cooperative kung nakikipag-cooperate sila with the other cooperative. And of course, concern for the community. Okay, kasi yung mga cooperative, dapat meron sila mga project din, okay, na makakatulong sa community. Kaya meron natin tinatawag na community development fund. Kasi kung wala silang mga activity that will be helpful to the community, baka bumagsak sila sa social audit. Okay? Kaya yun yung concern for the community. Now, let us proceed now sa objectives and goals of cooperative. Okay, under the law, sabi ng Article 7, ang primary objective daw ng cooperative is to help improve the quality of life of its member. Okay, yan yung primary objective ng cooperative, improve yung quality life, okay, quality of life ng members. Okay, in order to achieve this objective, okay, ang aim nila, mag-provide ng good or services to its member. Okay? Another is to provide optimum social and economic benefit to its member. Teach the members an efficient way of doing things in a cooperative manner, maging more efficient sila. Spread or propagate cooperative practices and new ideas in business and management. Okay, to increase ownership in the wealth of the nation. Okay, kasi di ba lahat ng members, okay, technically, okay, owner sila ng cooperative. Okay, and of course, cooperate with government, other cooperatives, and people-oriented organization. Okay, katulad yan, halimbawa, housing cooperative, di ba? Ang primary purpose ng cooperative, mag-provide ng housing among the members, di ba? Kaya nag-provide yan ng goods or services to its member. Okay, and of course, nai-improve nga yung quality of life ng mga members. Now, punta tayo sa powers and capacities. By the way, ang powers ng cooperative, pwede rin express or implied. Pag express, edi yan yung nakalagay mismo doon sa provision sa cooperative law. Makikita mo yan sa Article 9. Pero pag implied, okay, hindi siya nakalagay, hindi siya naka-indicate expressly, pero lahat ng act ng gagawin ng cooperative na reasonably necessary para maintain nila yung purpose na naka-indicate sa Article of Cooperation, that is an exercise of implied power. Kaya ano ba yung mga express powers ng cooperative? Yan. To the exclusive use of its registered name. Kaya ibig sabihin yung registered name nila, yung pangalan na binigay nila na naka-registered sa CDA, sila lang ang mayroong right na gumamit ng pangalan na yun. Pwede silang magdemanda at pwede rin silang idemanda. Okay? Meron silang right of succession. Kasi meron silang right mag-exist dun sa period na naka-indicate sa Article of Cooperation regardless of change in members. Next, may power silang mag-amend ng Article of Cooperation. Mag-adapt ng bylaws na hindi raw contrary to law, morals, public policy, and to amend and repeal the same. Ito naman yung power ng cooperative mag-purchase ng property at mag-enter ng contract. Okay, to purchase, receive, take, or grant, hold, convey, sell, lease, pledge, mortgage, and otherwise deal with such real and personal property as the transaction of the lawful affairs of the cooperative may reasonably and necessarily require subject to limitation prescribed by law and the Constitution. Actually, kung titingnan mo nga, itong number one na yan, labas inherent power din nila yan. Kumbaga, consequence yan ng pagiging juridical person ng cooperative. And syempre, hindi makakagalaw of course yung cooperative kung wala silang power mag-acquire ng property. Kasi yan ay consequence din ng pagiging juridical person. Kaya yun nga, pwede sila mag-purchase, okay, magbenta, mag-lease, mag-pledge, mag-mortgage, at mag-enter ng contract. To enter into division. Okay, yung division, kakaiba to, di ba? Kasi pag sinabi nating division, yung single cooperative, pwede siyang mag-split into two. Okay, pag merger naman, parang dun sa corporation setup, dalawang cooperative, pwedeng mag-merge into one. Okay? Pero sa merger, di ba, meron tayong tinatawag na surviving cooperative. Sa consolidation, pareha sila mawawala, mag-create kayo ng tinatawag na consolidated cooperative. Another is to form subsidiary cooperatives and joint federation or unions. To avail of loan daw, be entitled to credit and to accept and receive grant, donation, and assistance from foreign domestic sources. Yan, may power silang maka-receive ng donation either from foreign or domestic sources. Pero take note, para ma-maintain nila yung kanyang autonomy and independent, diba? One of the generally accepted cooperative principle. Kailangan, hindi pwedeng mag-enter sila ng loan, okay, or makareceive sila ng grant, okay, or donation, na may provision na pwedeng mag-interfere yung donor, okay, or yung lender, okay, dun sa management. Kasi ma-undermine yung kanilang autonomy of cooperative. Kasi di ba isa yan sa general accepted cooperative principle. Kaya dapat walang provision dun na pwedeng mag-interfere yung grantor, donor, or lender na pwede silang mag-interfere. Para wag ma-violate yung autonomy and independent ng cooperative. Now, to avail of preferential right daw under the local government code and other laws, particularly those in the grant of franchises to establish, construct, operate, and maintain ferries, wharves, market or slaughterhouses, and to lease public utilities including access to extension and on-site research services and facilities related to agriculture and fisheries activities. To organize and operate schools in accordance with the Governance of Basic Education Act of 2001 and other pertinent laws. Pero pansin mo, pag implied power, sabi dyan, to exercise other, such other powers granted by this code or necessary to carry out its purpose or purposes as stated in the Article of Cooperation. Kaya ibig sabihin, lahat ng act na gagawin ng cooperative na reasonably necessary yan, para ma-carry out nila yung purpose or purposes na ka-indicate dun sa Article of Cooperation, hindi siya technically ultra vires. Okay? Nag-act sila within the express. Okay? Within the power conferred, which is an implied power. Now, what are the requirements for registration of cooperative? Kasi pag halimbawa, gusto nyo mag-organize ng cooperative, ano ba ang requirement? Sabi ng batas, okay, every group of individuals. Ito yung tinutukoy ko dito, I'm referring to a primary cooperative. Okay? Na not less than 15 natural persons. Or pwedeng cooperative mismo ang organizer. Okay? Pero I'm referring to secondary and tertiary cooperative. Intended to form, okay, a cooperative under this code shall submit to the authority 4 copies daw. Kailangan nyo ng 4 copies each dito. Una, kailangan ng Article of Cooperation. Okay, second, kailangan nyo ng okay, sworn statement or treasurer's affidavit na nakalagay na at least 25% ng authorized share capital must be subscribed and at least 25% ng total subscription must be paid. But in no case should the paid share capital be less than 15,000 pesos. Pero by the way, under the old law, yung 6938, prior to okay, Republic Act 9520, lumalabas ang dating minimum paid up capitalization before is 2,000 pesos lang. Pero under Republic Act 9520, lumalabas is now 15,000 pesos. Tapos another is bylaws, bands of accountable officers. Pero take note, itong band of accountable officers kasi, di ba meron tayong, yung mga officers lang, ang magpo-post ng band dito, yung mga officers lang ng cooperative na may custody ng fund or asset ng cooperative. Okay, nagpo-post sila ng bond just for faithful compliance kasi baka nga naman itakbo nila yung asset ng cooperative. Kaya normally kung meron kang custody ng fund, okay, or asset ng cooperative, you need to post a bond. Okay? Now, makita mo yan sa Article 56. Another is the general statement daw, okay, describing the structure. Ah, ito, take note ha, bago to sa RA 9520 yung bookkeeper. Mandatory requirement na dapat yung organizational structure ng cooperative, there must be a bookkeeper. Tapos nakalagay yung purposes ng proposed cooperative. Another is the economic survey, kailangan yan, indicating therein the area of operation, ilan yung size of membership, and other pertinent data daw in a format provided by the authority. And of course, ito required dun sa Memorandum Circular Number 2016-2 yung Certificate of Pre-Membership Educational Seminar, PMES, signed by CDA PMES team. And of course, yung copy ng registration fee. Kaya pag yan, na-comply mo lahat yan, okay, at sasubmit mo yan sa CDA. Ngayon, pag halimbawa, yung CDA na-satisfy na na all requirement ng cooperative law has been complied with, then the CDA will now issue a certificate of registration under the seal of the authority. At doon magko-commence ang legal personality ng cooperative organized under this code. Okay, kaya ito ha, yung Article 17. Okay, parang same din siya doon sa corporation law. Magkaiba lang ang tawag kasi doon sa corporation law, di ba ang tawag natin ay okay, magko-commence ang legal personality ng corporation organized under this code from the time of the issuance ng certificate of incorporation under the seal of the okay, commission. Okay, which is the Security and Exchange Commission. Pero dito naman, magko-commence ang legal personality okay, ng cooperative organized under this code from the time of the issuance ng certificate of registration under its official seal. Now, take note that once the okay, CDA issue a certificate of registration under its official seal, that is a conclusive evidence daw okay, that cooperative ay duly registered under this code. Okay? Unless, syempre, okay, na-prove that the registration thereof has been cancelled. Now, illustration, under the Philippine Cooperative Code of 2008, Republic Act 9520, which of the following capitalization of ordinary cooperative comply with the requirement of law? Okay, syempre, ang rule is at least 25% ng authorized share capital must be subscribed and at least 25% ng total subscription must be paid. But in no case, should the paid share capital be less than 15,000 pesos. Kaya syempre, ekes na to. Ekes na rin yan. At ekes na rin yan. Kaya lumalabas ang natira ay yung 20. Okay? Answer is letter B. Pero by the way, sabi ko nga sa inyo before, okay, under the old law, yung 6938, lumalabas ang minimum paid up capital is only 2,000 pesos. But it was increased to 15,000 in Republic Act 9520. Pero by the way, may mga special ko, may mga other cooperative, special cooperative like multi-purpose cooperative. Ano ba yung multi-purpose cooperative? Ito yung cooperative na kinumbine yung two or more types of cooperative. Halimbawa, credit cooperative ka, the same time consumer cooperative ka. Then you become a multi-purpose cooperative. At under the implementing rules, lumalabas ang minimum paid up capital okay, ng multi-purpose cooperative is at least 100,000 pesos or the amount required by the feasibility study, whichever is higher. Now, ayan, iba yan. Okay, nasa implementing rules. Pero but on ordinary cooperative, of course, the minimum paid up capital is only okay, 15,000 pesos. Now, ito yung binanggit ko sa inyo class, ha? Multi-purpose cooperative is one which combines two or more of the business activity of these different types of cooperative. Yeah, yun nga, sabi ko, primary, cooperative, okay, tapos, lumalabas is, credit cooperative, the same time, consumer cooperative ka, magiging multi-purpose cooperative ka. By the way, class, ha, pag create kayo ng multi-purpose, pwedeng mag-create ka kagad ng multi-purpose cooperative, at i-comply mo lahat ng requirements set forth ng implementing rules. Especially yung paid up capital requirement. Or pwede mong i-transform yung single cooperative into multi-purpose cooperative. Provided na comply din yung minimum paid up capital requirement, pero dapat nasa operation ka na for at least 2 years. Kaya dapat 2 years nang nasa operation yung single cooperative bago mo siya ma-transform into a multi-purpose cooperative. Now, exception dito sa capitalization, agricultural cooperative saka agrarian reform cooperative. Okay, next. Okay, now let us summarize. Okay, di ba yung mga organizer, kailangan ko ng at least 15 or more natural person for primary cooperative. Tapos lahat sila ay Filipino citizen. Legal age, meron silang common bond of membership. At lahat sila ay residing or working in the intended area of operation. Tapos gagawin nila, magsasubmit sila ng 4 copies ng Article of Cooperation, 4 copies ng Bylaws, General Statement, okay, Economic Survey, tapos yung Treasurer's Affidavit na nakalagay doon at least nga 25% ng authorized share capital must be subscribed and at least 25% ng total subscription must be paid but in no case should the paid share capital be less than 15,000 pesos. Tapos yung band ng accountable officer. Okay? Now, except cooperative union yan ha. Okay? Saka dito, cooperative union din. Okay? Pagkatapos niyan, isasubmit nyo na or ipofile nyo sa CDA. Ngayon, meron lang naman dalawang option ang CDA. either i-approve siya or i-deny. Ngayon, pag in-approve, then the CDA will issue a certificate of registration under its official seal. And from that moment, magko-commence na ang legal personality ng cooperative organized under this code. At yan ay conclusive evidence, okay, na yan ay duly registered under this code. Okay, kaya yung dalawang effect niyan ha, makaka-acquired ng juridical personality. Tapos pangalawa, conclusive evidence siya. Okay na yung cooperative ito ay duly registered under this code. Ngayon, however, under the law kasi, binibigyan lang ang CDA ng 60 days to act on all application. Kaya kapag nagkaroon ng inaction sa part ng CDA for 60 days, that is deemed approval of the application. Now, sabi mo, sir, hindi ba dapat considered denied? Kasi di ba normally ganyan yung mga cases eh, pag ano, hindi nag-act yung government agency, denied. The answer of course here is no, because remember, yung policy ng state, di ba, pinopromote niya, ine-encourage niya yung mga private sector na mag-organize ng cooperative. Kaya dito, pag nagkaroon ng doubt, i-resolve siya in favor of the cooperative. Kaya in action sa part ng government agency, which is CDA in this case, that is deemed approval of the application. Okay, or second, i-deny. May express denial. Ngayon, pag dinenay for instance ng ng CDA ang inyong application for registration. Okay, ang gagawin nyo ay mag-appeal kayo before the office of the president within 90 days upon receipt of the notice of denial. At yung office of the president, binibigyan naman ng batas ng 90 days para mag-act on that appeal. Kasi pag nagkaroon ng inaction sa part ng office of the president within 90 days, that is deemed approval of your appeal. Meaning that is deemed your appeal is thereby granted. Okay? Kaya lumalabas, granted yung appeal nyo. Kaya magkakaroon kayo ng separate legal personality. Now, syempre, baka tanong mo, sir, what if dininay siya ng office of the president? Walang nakalagay dyan, okay, sa batas. Okay? Now, of course, ang recourse ninyo, edi mag-reapply ka na lang. Okay? O kung halimbawa, mayroon namang grave abuse of discretion amounting to lack or excess of jurisdiction, o di pwede kayo mag-file ng petition for certiorari under Rule 65 ng Revised Rules of Court. Pero normally, okay, hindi yan gagrant kasi that is a political question. Kaya lumalabas kung may grave abuse of discretion lang. Kaya dito, normally, pag ganyang denied na ng Office of President, wala na. Okay? Mag-reapply ka na lang. Okay, kasi baka mamaya meron kang hindi na comply na requirement set forth ng CDA. Now, ito yung legal basis do sa mga binanggit ko. Sabi diyan, all application for registration daw shall be finally disposed of by the authority within a period of 60 days. Kaya binibigyan lang ng batas yung government agency na CDA ng 60 days lang para mag-act on the application. Kasi pag nagkaroon ng inaction on their part, then that is deemed okay, approved. Ang exception of course, if the cause of the delay is attributable to the applicant. Kasi baka mamaya, yung nagkaroon ng delay sa part ng CDA na 60 days, because due to the fault nung okay applicant, okay, kaya lumalabas, okay, hindi siya deemed approved. Exception to. Okay? Now, sabi naman dito sa second paragraph, an appeal daw siya lie with the office of the president. Kaya nga sabi ko sa inyo, pag dininay siya, appeal ka sa office of the president. Kasi ang CDA, under lang yan ng office of the president. Kaya appeal ka sa office of the president within 90 days daw from the receipt of such denial. Tapos bibigyan din class ang office of the president ng 90 days para mag-act on that appeal. Okay? Otherwise, that is deemed approval of said application. Now, let us proceed now sa content ng Articles of Cooperation. Okay, parang sa corporation do, ginagawa kong mother provision yung article. Kasi marami diyang related article. Okay, doon naman sa corporation do, maraming related sections doon. Kaya, okay, ano ba yung content ng article? Saka ito yung nagsiserve as contractual relation kasi between the okay, organizer ng cooperative and the state. Now, unang makikita mo dyan is the name of the cooperative, which shall include the word cooperative. Kaya dapat meron kayong extension word na cooperative, cooperativa, or cooperativa. Chuva. Okay? Kaya yan ang nakalagay ha. Dapat may extension na cooperative, cooperativa, or cooperativa. Chuva. Shall be included in the name of the cooperative, which name shall likewise specify the type of cooperative. Kaya basically, pag gumawa kayo ng cooperative na name, dapat nakalagay doon yung types of cooperative. Halimbawa, katulad yan, sa amin is, halimbawa, Far Eastern University Credit Cooperative. Okay, halimbawa, ABC Credit Cooperative, ABC Electric Cooperative. Nakalagay doon yung type of cooperative nyo. Kaya kung dairy cooperative kayo, nakalagay din doon na dairy cooperative siya. Saka, under the law, sa Republic Act 9520, bawal kayong gumamit, of course, ng extension word na cooperative. Okay, cooperativa or cooperativa. Okay, kung hindi naman kayo duly registered under the law. Meaning under, okay, Republic Act 9520. Kung hindi naman kayo registrado sa CDA, bawal yung gamitin yung kanyang extension word na cooperative. Now, no cooperative name shall be allowed by the authority if the proposed name is identical. Parang same yan actually dun sa corporation do. Sa BP 68. Bawal kayong gumamit ng cooperative name na identical, deceptively, or confusingly similar of an existing cooperative or those name already protected by law. O kaya naman, okay, confusingly, similar to that of an existing cooperative, contrary to public policy, moral, and existing laws. Ngayon, ang pag-use daw ng word development and integrated shall be discouraged. Okay? Ito, makikita nyo sa implementing rules. Bawal kayong gumamit ng incorporated, corporation, company, incorporation, partnership, or other similar connotation. Bawal yan. The use of the word federation and union in the name of the proposed primary cooperative is likewise prohibited rin. Pero may exception, if it is part of the registered name of association or institution where the members of the proposed cooperative come from. Okay, name shall not be written in all capital letters. Bawal daw ha, lahat na capital letters except acronym lang. Kasi halimbawa, ginawa ko sa amin, halimbawa, Far Eastern University, pwede yung FEU. Okay, yung FEU lang ang pwede mong gawing capital letters. Okay? Now, sabi yan, acronym shall be written after the full name of the cooperative. Kaya pwede mong gawin yan pag gumawa ka ng name niya is Far Eastern University. Okay, tapos capital letter FEU. Tapos credit cooperative. O consumer cooperative. Basta kailangan nakalagay yung types of cooperative. Now, second, the purpose or purposes and the scope of business for which the cooperative daw is to be registered. Okay? Kumbaga sa corporation law, di ba, meron din kayong nakalagay, ano ba yung purpose or purposes ng corporation? Pag ang corporation ay may two or more purposes, ilalagay mo yung primary saka secondary purpose. Dito wala nang ginawang ganun. Basta kailangan ilagay mo yung purpose or purposes, bakit kayo, okay, sa kay scope ng business, so bakit kayo naka-registered. Ngayon, okay, ito yung mga purpose ng cooperative. Sabi dyan, a cooperative daw may be organized and registered for any or all of the following purposes. Okay, one, to encourage thrift and saving mobilization among members. Okay, to generate fund and extend credit to members for productive and provident purposes. By the way, class, ha, meron lang akong gustong isabihin sa inyo regarding sa mga purposes. Gusto ko gawin nyo ganito. Yung mga nakikita nyong purposes dito, purpose or purposes, dapat itugma nyo siya dun sa mga types of cooperative. Kasi halimbawa, katulad nito, to generate fund and extend credit to members, normally credit cooperative yan. Kasi ang concept ng credit cooperative, mag magko-contribute yung mga members sa cooperative, doon sa credit cooperative, pero later on, papautang din to doon among the members. Para in case na kailangan, for instance, yung mga members ng immediate fund, may papautang sa mga members. Okay? O kaya naman, nagpro-provide ka ng goods and services such as consumer cooperative. Okay? O kaya, nagpro-provide ng housing o the housing cooperative. Yep. Okay, nag-ano kayo ng insurance para doon sa mga losses ng members o insurance cooperative. Okay? Kaya yung mga nakalagay dito, itugma nyo doon sa mga types of cooperative. Okay? Now, ganun din dito, bangko, yan, cooperative bank, cooperative wholesale, and blah, 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 coordinate and facilitate the activities of cooperative to advocate, may tinatawag tayong advocacy cooperative. Ensure the viability of cooperative through utilization of new technologies to encourage and promote self-help or self-employment as an engine for economic growth and poverty alleviation, and to undertake any and all activities for the effective and efficient implementation of the provision of this code. Basta't kailangan, ito yung purpose na naka-indicate doon sa second paragraph ng Article of Cooperation. Okay, at normally, dapat nagtutugma yan doon sa mga types of cooperative na nakalagay sa RA 9520. Now, punta tayo sa term of existence. Okay, parang same sa corporation doon sa BP 68. Hindi sa Republic Act 11232. Kasi perpetual life na tayo, di ba, sa RA 11232. Pero doon sa BP 68, ang maximum period lang na pwedeng indicate sa Article of Incorporation, di ba, 50 years o ganun din dito. The maximum period that may be indicated under in the Article of Cooperation is only 50 years. Pero pwede siyang i-renew for another 50 years. And so on and so forth by amending the Article of Cooperation. Ang tawag lang iba eh, Article of Cooperation. Sa Corporation Law, Article of Incorporation. Dito, Article of Cooperation. Ngayon, similar din siya dun sa BP 68. Okay, na pwede lang kayong mag-amend ng Article of Incorporation, okay, within 5 years prior to the expiry date. O, dito naman sa cooperative, allowed lang kayong mag-amend ng Article of Cooperation for extension ng cooperative term within 5 years prior to the original or subsequent expiry date. Okay? Pero dun sa bagong batas, di ba, sa RA 11232, 3 years na lang ang nakalagay doon. I-remind ko lang kayo. Kaya 5 years prior to the original or subsequent expiry date, dates unless there is justifiable reason. Ito yung exception. Kung meron kayong justifiable reason for early amendment. Okay? Or early extension. Now, next, punta tayo sa area of operation. Okay, ito naman yung area of operation. Tapos, and the postal address ng principal office. Sabi ng section 2 ng implementing rules ng 2008, ang area of operation daw refer to the area where the cooperative operates and where its members come from as provided for in their articles of cooperation and the bylaws. Okay, next, the names, nationality, and the postal address of the registrant. Okay, now, syempre yung name, okay, kung yan ay primary cooperative, dapat puros individual yan. Okay. Tapos, nationality, dapat lahat sila Pilipino. And of course, saan yung kanilang postal address. Okay? Another is the what we call common bond of membership. O, sabi ko sa inyo, di ba dapat may common bond of interest yung mga members. Now, sabi ko sa inyo, ang pwede nyong gamitin na common bond of membership under the implementing rules, apat. Pwede nyong gamitin residential, occupational, institutional, saka okay, associational. Now, at sabi ng implementing rules, isa lang ang dapat mong gamitin. Mamili ka kung residential ba, occupational, associational, or institutional. Pag residential, dapat lahat ng members must be working or residing in the same, okay, residing in the same place. Okay? Kaya dapat lahat sila residing in the same locality. Kung institutional naman, and they consist ng mga employees, workers, and officers of particular institution. Kaya nga, di ba sabi ko sa amin, okay, ang pwede lang maging members, yung employees lang. Okay? Employees lang nung, okay, or officers, okay, nung institution. Kaya mga empleyado, kaya kung outsider ka, hindi ka pwedeng mag-join kasi ang ginamit institutional. Associational, sabi niya, the members come from a registered and or recognized association, group, club, fraternity, religious group, cultural, and other similar aggregations. And of course, occupational, members come from same or allied profession or actual occupation. Kaya liba sabi ko, parehas, liba, farmers cooperative, dapat lahat ng members dito must be farmers. Okay, kung gagamitin natin yung occupational, meaning they belong to the same occupation. Okay, another is the list of name of director who shall manage the cooperative. By the way, ang ato, name ng directors daw. Okay, ang directors natin is not less than 5 but not more than 15. Okay, parang same siya sa BP 68. Okay, who shall manage the cooperative. Another is the amount of share capital. Okay, yan yung capitalization, share capital, tapos nakalagay yung names, residence, contributor, and statement of whether the cooperative is primary, secondary, or tertiary in accordance with Article 23 hereof. Kaya lalagay nyo ha kung anong cooperative yan, primary ba? Kasi ang member ng primary is natural person. Pag secondary, ang members ay primary. And tertiary, the members are those secondary. Now, question. Yung share capital, okay, normally, ordinary shares yan. Pero ang tanong ko is this, pwede ba kayong mag-create ng share capital na preferred? Di ba ang gandang tanong? Pwede bang preferred shares? Okay, doon sa share capital. The answer is yes. Pwede. Provided nakalagay yan sa, ilagay mo lang sa article, syempre. Kaya meron ka nakalagay na preferred shares. Pero may limitation yan kasi under the implementing rules, okay, dapat ang preferred shares nyo hanggang maximum of 25% lang nung total share capital. Kaya ibig sabihin kung ang share capital natin for instance is 10 million, dapat hanggang 2.5 million lang ang preference shares doon. Kasi 25% lang siya nung share capital. Okay, now may limit ba yung par value niyan? Okay, the answer is, nakalagay sa batas is any amount, not more than 1,000. Pero problema, nag-conflict yan doon sa implementing rules because under the implementing rules, ang sinasabi, okay, ang par value niya is not less than 100 but not more than 1,000. Ibig sabihin, under RA 9520, naglagay ng maximum ceiling lang pero walang minimum. But under the implementing rules, lumalabas, may minimum siya of 100 pesos. Okay, now, check nyo na lang yung problem. Okay, kung ano yung mas better answer siguro. Okay, kasi kung titignan mo yung implementing rules, technically, hindi ka pwedeng mag-issue ng okay, share capital na ang par value is 50 pesos. Kasi nakalagay yan, may minimum of 100. Okay, maximum of 1,000. Okay. Now, pero kung may choices, kunwari na 50, alin doon yung hindi pwedeng par value ng share capital, may 50, may 1.5. O, mas better na isagot mo yung 1.5. Bakit? Eh, kasi walang conflict both sa law as well as the implementing rules. Okay, pero yung 50 kasi, mag-conflict sa implementing rules, pero walang conflict dun sa law. Kasi walang nakalagay sa batas ng minimum par value. Another is the article of cooperation may also contain any other provision though not inconsistent with the code or any related law. Kaya pwede kang maglagay ng any provision dito, wag lang siyang magko-conflict sa provision ng cooperative law or any related law, which is our special law. Now, what are the categories of cooperative in terms of membership? Kaya pag category, tinatanong siya, category ng cooperative as to membership, pwede primary, secondary, and tertiary. Ah, by the way nga pala, sa balikan ko lang to. Baka may tanong kasi ako sa inyo. Ano ba yung purpose bakit may preference shares ka dito? Alam mo, gusto ko mag-create ng preferred. Kasi ang reason class dito is this. Yung preferred shares kasi, normally, ini-issue ko yan sa mga associate member. Kasi dalawang members ng cooperative, di ba? Regular saka associate member. Pag regular member, entitled to vote yan. Pero pag associate member, wala silang right to vote. Kaya normally, yung mga okay, preferred, binibigay sa mga associate, yung mga walang right to vote. Okay, pero kung lahat bibigyan mo ng right to vote yan, wala ka kasing create na associate member, in that case, better mag-create lang ng one share capital, which is the ordinary share. Okay, now next. Pabalin ha, member of which are natural person. Pag secondary, ang members nito ay primaries. Okay, and tertiary, of course, is the secondary cooperative. Okay. Now, yun ha, bali yung number 9, any other provision not inconsistent with this code or other related. Okay, next, punta naman tayo sa content ng bylaws. Kanina, content ng Article of Cooperation, ito namang Article 15 is the content of the bylaws. Nakalagay dyan yung qualification for admission, okay, to membership. Kaya, lalagay mo ni yung qualification para ma-admit ka as member. Okay. Siyempre, kailangan lang merong common bond of membership. Diba? And the payment to be made or interest to be acquired as a condition for exercise of the right of membership. By the way, class, kailan ka ba magiging deemed member ng cooperative? From the time of the approval ng board of director. Pero as to right kasi, kailan ka pwedeng mag-exercise ng right as member? O, siyempre, answer, normally, upon payment. Okay, nung membership fee. Okay, or upon contribution. Kaya pwede mong ilagay yan dito sa bylaws. Kaya yung nakalagay yan, payment to be made or interest to be acquired as a condition for exercise of the right of membership. Another is right and liabilities ng member. May mga right and liabilities ng member, lagay nyo sa okay, bylaws. Kasi ito yung internal rules of management ng cooperative. Circumstances under which membership is acquired, maintained, and lost. So, pwede mo ilagay. Ano bang lumalabas na circumstances para ma-acquire mo yung membership. Okay, ma-maintain mo siya at kailan siya malulost. Procedure to be followed in case of termination of membership. Pwede nyo ilagay dito yung detailed procedure for termination of membership as part ng due process. The condition under which transfer of share of interest of member shall be permitted. Okay, kaya lalagay mo dyan ano yung condition para ma-transfer mo yung interest mo. Okay, number 6, the rules and procedure on the agenda, time, place, and manner of calling, convening, conducting meetings, quorum requirements, voting system, and other matters relative to the business affairs of the General Assembly, Board of Directors, and Committee. The general conduct of affairs of the cooperative, including powers and duties of the General Assembly, Board of Directors, Committee, and officers, and their qualifications and disqualifications. Manner in which the capital may be raised and the purpose for which it can be utilized. Okay, mode of custody of investment of the net surplus. Accounting and auditing system. Manner of loaning and borrowing including limitation thereof. Method of distribution of net surplus. By the way, class, ha, dun sa net surplus kasi sabi ko sa inyo. Okay, yung net surplus every year, meron kasing ginagawa yan, i-distribute yan. Meron kayong kailangang i-reserve na 10% sa reserve fund. Meron 10% sa okay, education and training fund. Pero nahati yan sa 5%, 5%. Itong 5% dito, yan yung mismong education and training. Yung 5% dito, ibibigay yan sa union or federation kung saan affiliated with yung cooperative. Tapos another is 3% community development fund, CDF. And of course, another 7% is the optional fund. Kaya pag dininan mo yan, 30% ang tawag dyan ay statutory reserve. Hindi mo pwedeng galawin yan. Kasi yan naka-reserve yan sa mga item na yan. Kaya technically, yung 70% lang ang pwede nyong i-distribute in the form of interest on share capital and the patronage refund. Pero by the way, ha, kung titingnan mo kasi, ang sabi ng batas, do sa first to 5 years of operation ng cooperative, halimbawa, newly organized cooperative ka, yung first to 5 years, dapat ang minimum okay reserve fund ninyo at least 50%. Kaya ibig sabihin, do sa first to 5 years, 50% reserve fund, 10% education and training fund, 3% sa community development fund, and 7% sa okay optional fund. Technically, 70% ang statutory reserve nyo doon sa first to 5 years. Okay? Kaya 30% lang ang pwede nyong distribute sa mga members in the form of interest on share capital and the patrons refund. Okay? Now, pero pag nag-lapse na yung 5 years na yun, pwede na siyang i-reduce. Okay, pero minimum is now 10% na. Now, oh, saka natin pag-usapan yung distribution ng net surplus kasi meron tayong separate topic dyan. Now, the manner of adopting, amending, repealing, and abrogating bylaws daw, conciliation or mediation mechanism, okay, for the amicable settlement ng dispute. Kasi baka mamaya, di ba may away-away yung mga members, members and directors, okay? Now, in that case, okay, huwag ka agad magkaso-kaso kasi pwede kayo magkaroon ng conciliation or mediation mechanism. For early disposition, okay, or possible amicable settlement para ma-settle yung dispute among them. And of course, other matters daw, incidental to the purposes and activities of the cooperative. Ito, bahala na kailagay kahit ano dyan. Basta ang kailangan lang, wag lang siyang magko-conflict sa provision ng law as well as the provision ng article of cooperation. Okay, now ito, gagawa na lang ako ng separate video. Break muna tayo. Okay, break muna mga kapatid. Okay.